Retirement planning is perceived as a strong indicator of financial freedom or independence. But the question is, how much the faculty members of business management and commerce and other disciplines are aware about it? And how much are they in a position to acquaint others about retirement planning? Now, as Ms. Monica Halan, consulting editor and part of leadership team at Mint, has rightly pointed in her book, Let's Talk Money, you are financially free when you don't need to work to pay your bills. You have enough assets that can generate enough income today and for the rest of your life. So with the excellence of wit, she mentions that some people say that money put in retirement planning is the go to hell money because it would be used after a long gap of time and you will have to curb your desires to use the money immediately. I suggest you to read her book, where she has equated retirement planning with oxygen mask. Very interesting. A recent survey called HSBC Future of Retirement Study has conservatively observed that about half of the people in India are not planning their retirement properly. One of the research scholars at Banasthali has concluded in her research that teachers in general do not have much awareness and concern about retirement planning, and relatively, the married women teachers are more concerned about retirement planning. As the knowledge flows in general, a comfortable retirement planning is becoming a priority in life. However, the Center for Personal Finance at Banasthali Vidyapith, our research points that many teachers still are ignorant about the retirement planning owing to the aspects like, I am too young to think about it, or I would work even after retirement, or I would retire late, or I will have good wealth, or I have good wealth, or I will anyway have 50 lakhs in my PF at retirement, or retirement planning is just a gimmick, or my children would take care, or I may not live beyond 70 years, and so on. But let me tell you that most of the above views rest on weak foundation. And therefore, we as the teachers should not only be more aware about retirement planning, but also look to sensitize our students, colleagues and others to meticulously plan for retirement. And therefore, I would like to tell you about the common mistakes in retirement planning which we should avoid. Now, the first is that retirement planning should not be viewed as the only issue of personal financial planning. So there are, you can say, many more, like estate planning, tax planning, liquidity planning, expenditure planning and budgeting. Also investment planning, risk management and not to forget philanthropy. In fact, we have other goals also like repaying the old loan or expenses on wedding, etc., or dependents, they may need money. The second is underestimating the expenses of the future. Now, this is further explained by the fact that inflation eats our money. And therefore, if your expenditure is 50,000 per month in January 2030, then at an assumed inflation of 7%, this amount would shoot to how much in January 2040? Do you know? I tell you, about 1 lakh per month. Another mistake is the perception that retirement planning is the exercise worth doing in the last 10 years of job. This is not the right approach. The earlier is better. So, if you start saving early, good for you. Next error is the belief that retirement planning is all about ensuring regular income. And therefore, just look for investments that would give monthly income or be entirely dependent on the pension. However, friends, What about a sudden requirement of large amount of money to meet a contingency? So, this has to be given a thought. With this, the next mistake is lack of strategy to estimate contingencies, and researchers have shown that those who are unprepared have to pay a heavy cost to manage unforeseen situations. The sixth mistake is confusion about your post-retirement lifestyle. Would you live in more lavishly or be very conservative, or depending on the situation, what will you do? So, needless to mention, these involve different requirement of money. Another could be underestimating the merit of healthcare. This is a very big mistake. In unfortunate case of hospitalization of you or your dependents, you know, substantial hit is imminent unless you have a well thought healthcare cover and policy. So, see, that is also one issue. Now, dear teachers, finally, some people ignore the merit of diversification. Investing only in bank FDs or only in the equity mutual funds or only in gold has its own dangers. In fact, it is really worth to consult personal financial planner to find out which asset mix and the choice of avenues would be suitable for you in wake of your investment objectives, constraints, goal and the environment.
Professor Purohit, you have mentioned that retirement planning is not just only about obtaining regular income, but still, post-retirement, if I would require to meet my monthly expenses, how to do this?
Yes, so Dr. Khyati, while regular income is not everything when it comes to retirement planning, but those who are mainly looking for retirement planning with a regular income, they should go for monthly income scheme. Reverse mortgage can also be one thing. Then combo of systematic plan and plan, they can plan the systematic withdrawal plan, fixed deposits or bonds with monthly interest, NPS and also annuity. So, all these could be considered. All of them have their merit and shortcomings and require an optimal mix, and this is one more reason to consult a personal financial planner who is like a financial doctor. So, regular income can be obtained and avenues are many.
I have also heard that reverse mortgage is also a way to earn regular income. Is it correct?
Yes, Dr. Khyati, although not the best one, I would say, but under the reverse mortgage, which is the opposite of home loan given by the bank, it provides monthly payments to the owner of the property till the owner is alive or till the owner desires. After the death, the bank may sell the house or ask the legal heir to settle the dues, and if not, the bank recovers its dues by selling the house and gives the balance, if any, to the legal heirs. And there are different schemes, but not much popular and pushed by the banks. Renowned financial journalist Ms. Vivina Vishwanathan of the Mint has authored a very good article some years back on reverse mortgage, which one may Google and read. Now, she has quoted an example that for a 1 crore rupees property, the bank may pay rupees 8200 every month up to 20 years, and after this, even if the owner is alive, she can live in the house till her death. So, if one wants higher monthly payment, conditions may change. In certain cases, reverse mortgage is a better option. So, one can consider this, but the awareness about reverse mortgage, I would say, is relatively lesser.
So, Professor Purohit, what is the Bharatiya perspective on retirement planning, particularly on our ashram system and other cultural issues?
Yes. So, Dr. Khyati, the Bharatiya perspective in retirement planning is indeed very strong. We need to understand that the Bharatiya perspective is deeply rooted in the law of karma phal and the fact that there is a rebirth. So, as of now, I have discovered five perspectives which I call the Panch Siddhant. The first perspective is that with the time, we should keep reducing our desires. Sri Aurobindo has suggested conquering the desires. Bhajans by Baba Gorakhnath and Kabir and Guru Nanak Dev have advocated a control on the senses. Now, what's the impact? Reduction in the expenditure, which in turn takes care of inflation to a large extent and leads to peace. The second is that if we impart the right sanskar to our children, they would take care and support us. In fact, you would be happy to know that 70% of the Indians, as per a HSBC survey, mentioned that they are confident of their children supporting them after retirement. Now, how many in the West can claim so? Not many. The third is very interesting. Do not save too much that is beyond what you may actually need. The Western view is that money says, save me today and I will save you tomorrow. While the Bharatiya perspective is that money says that I will not go with you after death, but my goodness can do. And so, if you spend and invest following the dharma, you will have more confidence when you say bye-bye through the world. The fourth is that do not plan your retirement kitty by snatching the money from others. It does not help. And the final one requires a very deep thought, that even if you face some hardships and do not have adequate money, which leads to lot of sufferings, perhaps that is because of prarabdha, that is our actions or karma in the previous births. A person with wisdom would always forgive those who have troubled him, accept the sufferings and desire not to take the next birth. Retirement planning for teachers, from the knowledge acquisition to dissemination, that goes on. So, Bharatiya perspective, I would say, is a superior tool, and one cannot underestimate the power of it. We as teachers need to understand the various investment avenues, nature and associated risks, and acquaint our students about them. So, if our students start early for the retirement planning after they get a job, of course, then in long run, it would be significant contribution of all of you for social security of our nation. So, if you have any questions on retirement planning, please feel free to email us on the ID fp@banasthali.in.